President, please be seated.
Le président. Veuillez vous asseoir.
The court is now in session.
Je déclare l'audience ouverte.
For today and tomorrow's proceedings, the trial chamber will hear statements of harms and sufferings.
La chambre entendra la déclaration des souffrances des participants.
By certain civil parties during the Democratic Gambia period, in relation to the facts at Bang Tomorrow and First January Dams, there are four of them, TCP 991,
donc TCCP
992, 992, 993,
993,
and lastly two TCCP 994.
994.
The said civil parties who will come, firstly, will be the TCW 991.
Nous entendrons d'abord de TCCP 991.
Greffier, Mr. Amhoy, please report the attendance of the parties and other individuals at today's proceedings.
Monsieur le greffier, veuillez faire votre rapport.
Greffier, Mr. President, for today's proceedings, all parties to discuss are present.
Toutes les parties à l'audience sont présentes aujourd'hui.
Mr. Nuji is present in the holding cell downstairs. He has waived his right to be present in the courtroom.
Il a renoncé à son
the waiver has been
physiquement présent dans le présent.
Delivered to the greffier.
Et le document en ce sens
a civil party who is to present statements of harms and sufferings
qui comparaît aujourd'hui
include TCCP 991
ou plutôt 992, parmi les parties civiles qui comparaîtront aujourd'hui nous avons TCCP 991 992 993 et 994 dans cet ordre.
The four civil parties are present awaiting to be called by the chamber.
Thank you. D'être convoqué par la chambre.
President, thank you, Mr. Amhoy.
Merci, Monsieur le greffier.
The chamber now decides on the request by Nuon. The chamber has received a waiver from Nuon dated 1st September 2015, which states that due to his health, headache, back pain, he cannot sit or concentrate for long, and in order to effectively participate in future hearings, he requests to waive his right to participate in and be present at the 1st September 2015
hearing.
He has been advised by his counsels that in no means the waiver can be construed as a waiver of his rights to be tried fairly or to challenge evidence presented through or admitted by the court at any time during the trial.
Having
seen the medical report of Nuji by the duty doctor for the accused at the ECCC dated 1st September 2015, who notes that Nuji has chronic back pain when he sits for long and recommends that the chamber grant him his request so that he can follow the proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs. Based on the above information and pursuant to Rule 81.5 of the ECCC internal rules, the chamber grants Nuji his request to follow today's proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs via audiovisual means. The AV unit is instructed to link the proceedings to the room downstairs so that he can follow the proceedings. That applies for the whole day.
Toute la journée.
And before questions approach to noting the objection by the co-defense counsel for appeal some point in relation to the use of document E319/25/3/24 rather, which was a submission by the lead co-lawyers for civil parties on the 25th August 2015. That is Annex A of document EC19/31. The Chamber would like to inquire with the lead co-lawyers for civil parties whether you still maintain your position on the use of the said document, that is EC19/25.3.24, after the said civil party has been the civil party through TCCP 995 has been removed from the list.
En effet, for the statements of plans and sufferings.
Merci, Monsieur le Président, et bonjour à tous. Bonjour
au
parti. Thank you,
Mr. President, and good morning to everyone. Good
morning nous to the parties. Avons eu les conclusions de l'équipe de Kyo Sampan et nous n'avons pas d'objection à ces conclusions dans la mesure où nous avions présenté les documents pertinents pour cinq parties civiles.
On the five civil parties.
Une des parties civiles qui devait témoigner devant cette chambre aujourd'hui a dû annuler à la dernière minute. Il n'y a donc pas de difficulté de notre côté pour que le document relatif à cette partie civile ne soit pas considéré comme admis par la Chambre. Nous avions simplement suivi les recommandations de la Chambre sur la nécessité de déposer une requête.
President, the lead co-lawyer for civil party, you may continue.
Vous pouvez poursuivre.
Pour simplifier, nous avions inclus ce document, puisque cette partie civile était censée venir témoigner devant cette chambre. Nous avons informé la Cour et les parties vendredi que cette chambre n'était pas, que cette partie civile n'était pas disponible. Nous nous en remettons à l'appréciation de la Chambre quant à savoir si ce document devra être admis ou non. En tout état de cause, de notre côté, nous n'entendons pas utiliser ce document dans la mesure où la partie civile ne viendra pas témoigner lors de cette audience sur l'impact des crimes. J'espère avoir clarifié la position du côté des parties civiles.
President, thank you. The chairman would also like to inform the parties and the public that for the afternoon session, before we continue our proceedings, the chairman will resolve the issues concerning the key documents that were heard last week.
En rapport avec ce dont il a été discuter la semaine dernière.
Court officer, please, usher civil party to TCCP 992 into the courtroom for the presentation of statements of harms and sufferings, as well as the TPO staff.
Veuillez aussi faire entrer la personne de la TPO qui l'a compris.
Monsieur le Président, juste peut-être une demande de clarification. Pendant que la partie civile s'installe, vous avez indiqué que nous discuterions des documents clés cet après-midi, si j'ai bien compris. En tout cas, c'est ce qui nous est arrivé dans la traduction en français. Je voulais simplement avoir une clarification parce que, bien évidemment, il faudrait que nous nous préparions si la Chambre décidait d'avoir un débat sur les documents clés aujourd'hui, dans la mesure où cette information n'a pas été communiquée à l'avance aux parties.
has not been provided to us earlier. I mean to the parties earlier.
President, thank you. Maybe
Merci.
It's my mistake.
Peut-être,
However, allow me to clarify the matter. In fact, the matters had been decided by the Chamber on the issues of the key documents. So that the key document presentation can be scheduled in due course and once all those issues involved are ironed out. And for that reason, for this afternoon session, we provide such a decision on those issues. So there is no debate on the key document presentation this afternoon, just to make it clear.
Voilà pour que ce soit bien clair.
President, good morning, Madame Civil
Bonjour,
Party.
Madame la Partie
what
Civil.
Is your name?
Comment vous appelez-vous?
Good morning.
La Partie Civil.
Lawyers and everyone,
Bonjour,
my name is Nuon Narom. I was born in 1956
at Chamka Le,
district Kampong Cham province.
Dans la province de Kampong Cham.
President, thank you.
Le président.
And
Merci.
Where is your current address?
Où
and Madame Civil Party, please observe the microphone.
Madame, d'attendre que votre microphone soit allumé.
Civil Party, at present I lived in Phnom Penh.
Aujourd'hui j'habite à Phnom Penh.
Question, and
Question.
What is your current occupation?
Quelle est votre profession?
Answer.
Réponse.
In the 1980s, I worked for the
Dans les années 80,
SPK ministry.
Pour le
However, currently I stay
SPK,
at home.
Mais je suis aujourd'hui au foyer.
President, court officer, could you please observe the photographer?
Mais
is
si
he authorized to take photos in the courtroom?
Veuillez vérifier si la photographe a l'autorisation pour prendre des photos.
Please make that inquiry with the photographer.
Veuillez vérifier auprès du photographe.
President, what are the names of your parents, Madame Civil Party?
Le président poursuit. Comment s'appellent vos parents?
Civil Party. My father is Oi Chum and my mother is Nu Jaim.
Nu Jaim.
President, thank you.
President.
And what is the name of your husband and how many children do you have
comment
together?
Comment s'appelle votre époux? Combien d'enfants avez-vous?
Answer. My husband's name is
Pek
Anin.
We
have
two
children together. There is one son and one daughter.
Un fils et une fille.
President, thank you.
Le président.
The chairman would also like
Merci.
To inform the parties and the public that for
la
the proceedings of hearing the statements of harms and sufferings by some civil parties,
le cadre de l'audience sur les déclarations de
the
souffrance des parties civiles,
chamber has arranged a representative of a TPL staff to provide support to them during the time that they are here to make their statements of harms and suffering. We have Madame Chai Maridait this morning,
Madame Chai Maridait,
who is here on behalf of TPO.
TPO.
And Madame Civil Parties, the chamber will hand you the floor to make your statement of harms and sufferings
les souffrances et le
that inflicted upon you physically, subi. Materially, and emotionally,
physique, matériel,
which the direct result of the crimes and which led you to become a civil party in this case. That is relations to the two accused, Venucci and Kyu Sampon, that you think that their acts directly have an impact upon you for the period of
pourquoi vous considérez que leurs
agissements 17 April 1975 to 16 January 1979 and I noticed the international lead column is on her feet and you may proceed.
Vous avez la parole.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Comme nous l'avons fait lors de la dernière audience sur l'impact des crimes, nous souhaiterions avoir la possibilité, nous avocats, de poser quelques questions à la partie civile pour guider son témoignage sur le préjudice. Donc je souhaitais poser à la partie civile quelques questions pour lui permettre de structurer son témoignage sur le préjudice comme nous l'avons toujours fait lors de ces audiences. Donc je voulais simplement vous demander l'autorisation, Monsieur le Président, de procéder comme à l'accoutumée et de poser quelques questions à la partie civile lors de son témoignage.
As a matter of practice, the civil party is given the floor to make a statement of harms and sufferings. However, it was the choice of the litigious lawyers for civil parties to proceed the way that you requested because certain civil parties cannot make a statement on their own. And in fact, the chamber entertains the two options so far. However, first, we need to adhere to our initial practice. That is to give the floor to the civil party to make the impact statement. And if that is the case, it will be more authentic in the presentation of the statements of harms and sufferings. However, if she cannot make it, then we will entertain your request as the second option.
Nous pouvons retenir la deuxième option.
And if we decide just to entertain your option, it means that we lift out the first option as the practice, as certain civil parties are capable of making their own statements of harms and sufferings,
vous le demandez, cela veut so dire that que they would feel at ease in doing so.
For that reason, we adhere to our practice and proceedings, and if you wish to select the second option for the civil party, of course,
mais si pour cette partie civile, give you vous voulez la deuxième option,
that choice. So it is up to you whether to give the floor to the statement for the civil party to make statement,
or
you can decide to put the questions to the civil party. And that is the proceedings. And strictly speaking, the proceeding is for the civil party to make such a statement.
La possibilité and est donnée à la partie civile de faire sa déclaration.
Et ce n'est que si elle ne peut le faire, we will give you the floor que nous vous laisserons la parole questions
pour lui poser des questions.
And the chamber will entertain your request now so that you can put questions to this civil party
maintenant pour que vous puissiez poser des questions à la partie civile
plutôt que de laisser la partie civile faire sa
déclaration. Proceed. Vous avez la parole.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. La raison pour laquelle nous souhaitons poser des questions, c'est qu'il nous a été demandé que les parties civiles se concentrent sur le préjudice lié à un site en particulier, mais que nous souhaitons aider la partie civile et assister la Chambre et les parties pour que tout le monde comprenne l'histoire de cette partie civile et le parcours qui l'a amené sur ce site en particulier. Raison pour laquelle nous souhaitions poser quelques questions d'introduction pour que tout le monde comprenne bien l'histoire de cette partie civile et les raisons qui l'ont amené à travailler sur le barrage du 1er janvier, puisque c'est sur ce barrage.
President interrupts.
Le président.
We give you the floor already, so there is no need for lengthy explanation from
you. Nous avons déjà laissé la parole. Nous n'avons pas besoin d'avoir de longues explications.
And if you decide to put questions to her, of course, the floor is yours.
Si vous voulez lui poser des questions, allez-y.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you,
Bonjour, Madame la Partie civile.
Good morning, Madame
la Partie. Première question que je souhaiterais vous poser est une question de clarification.
Being asked for purposes of clarification.
Puisque vous avez signé votre constitution
Since
de parti civil
you
avec un nom différent de celui que vous avez donné au président aujourd'hui, et je me réfère au document E3/49/09. Le nom qui est indiqué dans ce document est le nom suivant que je vais prononcer probablement avec un accent inapproprié. Oui, Samna. Pouvez-vous indiquer quel est ce nom?
Can you tell us what that name is?
Super party, thank you.
Merci.
Oi Samna is my native name.
C'est mon nom de naissance.
That is when I was born, I was given that name.
C'est le nom
However, after 1979, while I was living with my relatives,
alors que j'habitais chez ma famille,
I continued using two names,
that
name and
the
Narom's name.
Et Narom.
And when I registered the name, and when I was not there on the day of the registration, then
quand
my relatives put
Nuon
as
donc,
my surname on the registration.
Ils ont mis Nuon.
And that is the case.
Comme nom. Voilà pourquoi.
Je vous remercie. Où viviez-vous
Thank you.
Le 17 avril 1975? Quel âge avez-vous à cette époque et avec qui, quel membre de votre famille
And
vous viviez à l'époque?
Which of your family members were you living at the time?
In 1975, I was evacuated to live in Phnom Penh, to live with my distant relative in Phnom Penh. However, due to severe bombardment, I went to take refuge in Wat Koh Ruda. And on the 17th of April 1975, we were together and we were evacuated via Monivong Boulevard, crossing
the
Chabampe Bridge,
pont de Chabampe.
And then we reached Kien Swai.
Et nous sommes arrivés à Kien Swai.
While we were en route, crossing the Chabampe Bridge,
sur le chemin que nous avions
the situation
traversé
was extremely difficult.
La situation était très difficile.
I had several of younger relatives and nephews who were 7-8 years old, and it took us hours before we could cross the bridge and arrive at Kedai Takoi,
a pagoda. La pagode de Kedai Takoi.
Rested there overnight, and my in-laws went to look for water to cook the rice for our nephews. We remained staying there for 4 or 5 days, then we decided to continue our journey to Kien Swai. However, the road was too crowded, we could hardly move, and we stayed overnight. The next day, at 10 a.m., we arrived at Kien Swai, and we were ordered by Khmer Rouge to board a motorboat to Preibu. We were given lunch at Preibu. Then, the Khmer Rouge took us again. That is my family and other families to Suom at the Tapao village in Suom. And we were separated into various villages.
Nous avons été répartis
my
dans
siblings
villages.
Were placed in other, in other villages while I was allowed to stay with my mother. A few days later, my in-laws, that is my sister's husband's, and one of my nephews were taken away for re-education. After 2 months, I was sent to Trapeang Thlong,
Krai Chi
Mon, and we were there for 4 or 5 months, and we were sent to Chamka Le, that is to Bay village.
Dans le village de Bay.
Still in Kampong Cham province.
Toujours dans la province de Kampong Cham.
And about 2 or 3 months later, I was by myself, and I was sent to enroll into a mobile unit at the lobby Le Pagoda.
Dans une pagode.
I was in that mobile unit
in 1977,
that is during 1977, if I recall it correctly. Then I was sent to build the first dinnery dam.
Envoyé construire le barrage du 1er janvier.
Once I arrived at the first January dam work site, a long shelter had been made already in the middle of the rice field, and it was roofed with hedge, with hay,
avec un toit de chaume.
And we were instructed to work day and night without any rest, and we also had to work at night.
As
we were told during the meetings that we had to work harder in order for the dam to be completed before the rainy season started. The situation was rather arduous. We had not enough food to eat. And as I said, the situation was extremely difficult.
And
for us women, we need proper sanitation, but on the contrary, we only had a pair of clothes on ourselves. We had to work day and night, and even when we were sick, we were not allowed to rest. And they said that if you are sick, you still have to go to work, and if you fall on the ground at the work site, then you would be allowed to rest. If we were considered to be inactive or lazy, that person would disappear, and there were many workers from where I worked disappeared. For that reason, despite my illness, I didn't dare to rest. I had to work. And we did not have proper drinking water to drink, but there was no such luxury. During the times that I worked there, we were allowed to rest for a brief period of time. Then a whistle was blown so that we had to get up from the
from the building,
and then we had to go and work. And the spot that I worked was near the Chinit River.
Près de la rivière Chinit.
And the shelter, that is the sleeping quarter, was about 3
3 kilometers
from the work site, and we had to walk every day.
Et donc, tous les jours,
and as for the sanitation,
there was no sanitation.
There were so many flies.
Très mauvaises, il y avait des mouches partout.
And some bad people could seek
certaines
some salt from the kitchen and share it with us. So sometimes we have a few pellets of salt
to supplement the food that we ate. La nourriture que nous mangeons.
And the soup was terrible.
Mais
it was cooked in a large
infâme.
Pot
elle était
with a very little
veggie
and meat.
Et avec
and we could only rest for a brief period of time, then we had to work
nous
again,
ne pouvions reposer que pendant
and then we returned in the late afternoon for dinner. We had a quick dinner, then we had to return to the work site to continue working at night time. I was about 18 or 19 years old at the time, and we had to carry the earth through the night.
Transporter de la terre toute la nuit.
The skin on my shoulder peeled from heavy load of earth on the basket. Then, sometimes during the night, we were instructed to return to the sleeping quarter, and sometimes we had to attend a meeting, and that happened every few nights. Then we could sleep, but it was only a few hours before we were woken up again by a whistle blow. There was a stream nearby the sleeping quarter, and we used the water from that stream. And of course, cows and buffaloes were washed also in that stream. We also washed our clothes and took bath there.
C'est là que nous
there was no sanitation at all.
Nos vêtements, c'était très mal propre.
We tried to survive with whatever we had.
Nous avons essayé de survivre.
And we really took a bath. Because
il était rare que nous
we only had the clothes that we put on.
Car nous n'avions qu'un seul ensemble de vêtements.
Hai pe da jeung pe jeung kapung rek dai kadau
chan chi sei tak. When we were carrying the dirt in the open sun, we could have water, but the water was muddy and it was brought to us. We had to drink, although it was not clean water. At night time, I sometimes dreamed that I could have a cold water to drink. The meetings would be held once in every 2 days. And we were told that if we were not inactive, and we would obstruct the wheel of the history, although we were sick, we had to go to work. Some of my colleagues, four or five of them, they had night blindness. At night time, I was the one who led them to work. And later on, there was a plan that we could have a rest once in every 10 days. And at one time, I could observe that the water was dirty and looked very green. The water that we drank. One day, my colleagues and I went into the forest to catch frogs and ants so that we could cook them for food to eat. During the 6 or 7 month periods of my work there, I bore the situation. It was a very hard work.
Le travail était extrêmement difficile.
And when our work site were moved close to a stream, they put the bamboo stick on the stream so that we could cross it to another side. The work condition was very harsh. We had no necessary tools to help us. And during the daytime, we had to pick up tneng leaves and put in our mouth to fill our stomach. So the 6 or 7 month period during that time was very difficult for me. I lived in a different place from my mother's work site. I witnessed that some of my colleagues were mistreated, although they were really sick, and these colleagues were not allowed to take rest. They verbally challenged or refused the assignment, and they were beaten at that time. So for me, I had to try my best to work. Some of my colleagues, those four or five, were beaten, and they were instructed to carry dirt. They were given with a big earth baskets to carry dirt. I could not say anything, but it was painful in my heart. I was doing my utmost at that time. I had to work.
Vraiment de mon mieux à l'époque. Je devais travailler.
Women had periods and they had cramps in their abdomen. They
les
need sanitation, but
we
were deprived of this. We were treated as animals.
Mais nous en étions privés, nous étions traités comme des animaux.
At night times, we starved, and at that time, I was working with my colleagues. Many of them, all
je
of them,
were deceased.
And at night time, when we were working, when I was working, I could observe there were some leaves and fruits. I asked some of my colleagues whether those kind of leaves and fruits were edible.
Était comestible.
I missed my mother. I had no information about my mother and siblings. I did not know at that time where they were living. I was living in an open field with no houses surrounding, and I did not know at that time the name of that location where I was living. At night times, when I went to sleep, I had to use whatever clothes to use as the sleeping mat, and I would also use hay for my sleeping mat. I also used my kroma or scarf to cover my ears so that the insects would not go into my ears. I don't think I had many hours to sleep at night. I had to wake up very quickly after I heard the whistle blown. At that time, I worked until the rainy season.
J'ai travaillé jusqu'à la saison des pluies.
And the roof was leaking. And the water would go through the roof during the rainy season. I mean the roof of my sleeping quarters. In July, when there were heavy rains, we could hardly do our work. At that time, I felt sick. I had a high temperature and I was tremble. I could not walk to Levier village. At that time, I asked for a ride on the cat. I met my mother. I asked my mother so that I could be allowed to go back to live with my mother. When I saw my mother at that time, she was skinny. I was seriously sick at that time. I was not allowed to stay in the village. I was referred to a hospital in the pagoda. I had cramps in my abdomen. Even a little water in my stomach, even I drank a little water, I could feel the pain. I was hospitalized for 2 weeks. 2 weeks later,
I felt better.
My mother was with me at the hospital, and when I recovered from the disease, I asked the permission to stay with my mother in the village, but I could stay there for a period of 2 months, after which I was sent back to a mobile unit to work in a farm.
Pour travailler dans une ferme.
I was growing vegetable or doing rice farming. Sometimes I was asked to go and pick up maize or corn.
Parfois, je devais aussi
One day,
récolter du maïs.
I saw the chief of Phum Bay village. And at that time, the biography was collected. My mother was asked whether some of my family members went to the East Zone. At that time, my family, my mother and I, responded frankly, and we told them that we were sent to Plong village in Kampong Cham. In 1978, perhaps in July or August, I was assigned to work in a plantation picking up corns. One day I was told to collect rice at a pagoda.
D'aller collecter du riz dans une pagode.
When I was standing at the kitchen, Mom, who was in the mobile unit, told me that our parents had been taken away to be killed. I lost my spirits and I almost dropped the container from my hands. And I asked Mom when our parents had been taken away, and Mom told me that they had been taken away in the morning. It was late for us to go back and help them. One person in the kitchen at that time knew that I did not have lunch, have meal yet, so I was offered meal, but I could not eat. I was staying in a very quiet place, crying and weeping. 4 or 5 days later, children of the parents who had been taken away were also taken away. Some of us at that time were told to pick up the beans because during that time the beans were ripe. And everyone was thinking that it would be our times to be taken away. I was in monk's cell. At that time, I wore a pair of sandals and I wore a set of clothes. When I was coming back to work, I saw the village chief who was holding a long knife. At that time, I was going to the plantation to pick corns. I told an individual at the corn plantation that it was my time now. And that person told me that we could not escape anywhere else.
Nous ne pouvions fuir ou nous échapper nulle part.
I spent some time during my work at that time to go to my relative's place. I met my relative that I had a permission one day to visit her. When I met her at her house, she went to cook food for me. Her house was roofed with leaves. When I was at her house, I saw the youth chief who were walking around, and I knew at that time that they were looking for me. A few minutes later, I went to my relative's mother's house to ask for medicine. I was given with some medicines to have. At the back of her house, there was a farm raising pigs. I was hiding myself at that farm. There were many children at that time crying and playing. I was hiding until the sunset. I could not go anywhere else because I was afraid. It was almost dark. And I decided to go back to my mobile unit.
Et j'ai décidé de revenir à mon unité itinérante.
While I was returning to corn plantation, I met with one of my colleagues, and she asked me where I was in the morning. Everyone that was looking for me, I told her that I went to my relative's house.
Je lui ai répondu que j'étais allé chez un
when
membre
it
de
was
la famille.
Dark, I went into a pagoda.
Lorsqu'il a fait nuit, je me suis rendu dans une pagode.
I met Main.
J'y ai rencontré Main.
And Main had a permission to visit her house for
Main
one night.
I
met her and
she
asked me where I was going. I told her that I was going back to the mobile unit. She told me not to go. And I was told that some people in my mobile unit had been taken away. I did not know where to go at that time. So I decided to go to one of my colleague's house,
d'aller chez un de mes collègues.
And I met my colleague at that time, and I met my aunt at that time, and she offered me
ma tante.
A stay
ma tante
at night time.
De me loger
and
pour la nuit.
At that time, she asked me whether I had a meal already.
Elle
I was offered
si
a meal or dinner at that time. My aunt asked me about my mother, where she was at that time. And I replied that my mother was fine. My aunt offered me the dinner at that time. I did not have dinner for a few days already, but I did not feel hungry at all.
Mais je n'avais pas faim du tout.
I spent a night at my aunt's house, and in the morning, when I heard the rooster sound, I left the house.
J'ai quitté la maison.
And I was trying to go back to my mobile unit.
Et j'ai essayé de retourner à mon unité.
I went via a road passing
j'ai emprunté une route
headwork or spillway. I was looking around to make sure that no one could see me. When I reached the corn plantation, I stepped on a spike. I fell to the ground and the spike tore my clothes. And subsequently, I reached a field. There was no one at that time. Upon my arrival at that field, went to Jane's house.
À ce champ, je suis allée à
la maison
de Jane.
To go and pick up some morning glory so that I could avoid the morning glory. I really wanted to die at that time.
Je voulais vraiment mourir à cette époque-là.
And while I was boiling the morning glory, the village chief and military chief asked for my cousin, and I told them that she was not at the house.
Je leur ai dit qu'elle n'était pas là.
And the village chief and youth chief met me and asked me where I was going, why I was staying at that house. I told them that I had just left the hospital and now I was visiting my cousin's house.
Et que j'étais en visite chez ma cousine.
And after they discussed with me, they told me that they would go to see the Sangkat chief. And in the afternoon, Sangkat chief, together with the two people, came to my cousin's house and asked me whether I had come from the east zone. I told them that I was from Bay Village. Then responded that they would call someone from village 3 to fetch me back.
De ce village pour
and
venir
a few moments later, I drank the morning glory water.
J'ai bu l'eau des liserons d'eau.
Later on, they came back again and gave me a meal. They told me to be loyal to Angka to avoid any incident happening to me. The Sangkat chief came from time to time to ask me about the situation. At that time, I was poisonous. At that time, I had a poisonous morning glory of water and I was not well. The Sangkat chief at that time told me that
je ne me sentais pas bien. Le
please
chef du Sangkat m'a dit,
do not feel worried and please make sure that I would like, he confirmed that I would be safe and sound. And he or she told me to stay in that house and to rest.
Cette personne m'a également dit de rester là où j'étais et de me reposer.
Frankly, the Sangkat chief was related to my aunt. And
franchement,
later
le chef
on, my aunt arrived at that house and
Ma tante
received
est ensuite arrivée
à
cet endroit. J'ai alors reçu un repas.
I was allowed to stay at
my
cousin's house for a few months, 5 or 6 months.
Pendant quelques mois,
but one day, there was the arrest was attempted to rather At one time, they wanted to arrest me.
Mais un jour, il y a eu une tentative d'arrestation
sur ma
personne.
I was trying to jump off the house at that time.
Et j'ai essayé de fuir la maison.
In 1979, I was told that there were no longer killings and arrests.
On m'a dit qu'il n'y avait plus d'arrestations
so
et qu'il n'y avait plus d'exécutions.
So I was lucky then to survive.
J'ai eu la chance.
Although I survived at the period, I was very lonely.
Même si j'ai survécu à cette période, j'étais bien seule.
I endured hardship. And I have no goal in my life after the regime. I have no relatives. I am alone.
De ma famille, j'étais toute seule.
I am very lonely. In 1982,
je me sentais vraiment seule.
My relatives who went to work in Phnom Penh,
les membres de ma famille sont
asked me to come and live with them, and I registered my name in the SPK. Ministry, said the witness. My life was a bitter in the regime.
In 1986,
my husband, who worked
mon mari,
in the agricultural ministry, married me. And we have been in marriage until now. We have two children, one son and one daughter.
Un garçon et une fille.
Merci, madame.
Thank you.
La partie civile.
Madame Civil Party.
Le temps avance et je souhaiterais vous demander
running out of time a little bit, and I would like
que ressentez-vous
to ask you,
quand vous repensez
what do you feel
à cette période,
when you think about that period?
De la douleur.
And I'd like to put questions to the accused through the president of the chamber.
Les questions aux accusés par le truchement du président de la chambre.
And if I permit, the following questions. The purpose of evacuation of people from cities, and that later on that they were being used,
leur utilisation
that they
par la
were
suite.
Overworked,
le fait qu'on les ait
what was the purpose of that?
À quoi ça a servi?
And as you knew, there was war before
vous
that, and then you evacuated them back into their hometowns,
et
and instead you accused them
natal.
Of being enemies.
Vous les avez
what was the purpose of that?
À quoi cela vous a servi? Quel était l'objectif de cela?
I have young nephews, and there were about 7 or 8 of them. Who was still very young and innocent.
J'avais 7 ou 8 neveux qui étaient jeunes et innocents.
And their lives were lost. And you.
Ils ont perdu leur vie et vous.
You killed so many people.
Vous avez tué tellement de personnes.
You killed your own people.
À maintes reprises, vous avez tué votre propre
peuple. What was the purpose of that? Did you want to replace the Khmer people by another group of people?
In
my area, there were serious area bombardment, and the scars of the bombs still remain today. People were very scared, And we did not dare to live in a hometown, so we went to take refuge in Phnom Penh City. But when we returned to our hometown, we were accused of being enemies. This is a real case of Catch 42. We have no chance. And we were accused of being a CIA agent in the network, etc. We didn't know anything about that. And you ordered the base people to mistreat us.
Et vous avez donné l'ordre au peuple de base de nous maltraiter.
To monitor us, to eavesdrop on us,
de nous espionner.
And to monitor every activity.
Surveiller tous nos mouvements.
Madame
Nuon, you finished your questions that you wish to put to the accused?
Avez-vous terminé de poser les questions que vous
I only have these two questions, Mr. President.
Monsieur le Président, je voudrais que ces deux questions
Madame Civil Party,
le Président.
The Chamber wishes to inform you that after ascertaining the position of both accused on 8 January 2015, regarding this exercise of the right to remain silent, the Chamber notes that the two accused maintains their express positions unless and until such time as the Chamber is expressly informed otherwise. By the co-accused or their counsels. It is therefore incumbent upon them to inform the Chamber in a timely and efficient manner so the accused resolves to waive the right to remain silent and be willing to respond to questions by the bench or relevant parties at any stage of the proceedings. As of today, the Chamber is not informed that the co-accused have changed their express position and thus agreed to provide their responses to questions. For that reason, the Chamber cannot order the accused to answer your two questions as they maintain their the exercise of the right to remain silent.
Se prévalent de leur droit à garder le silence.
And, litco lawyer, do you have any more questions to be put to the accused?
À poser à l'accusé?
À l'accusé, non. En tout cas, c'est ce que j'ai eu en traduction à la partie
accused,
civile non plus,
no.
Je crois qu'elle s'est parfaitement exprimée.
We do not have any
nous laissons
for the
la parole aux
either.
Autres parties.
She has spoken very well, and we now give the floor to the other parties.
Thank you, and it is now appropriate time for
Merci.
A short break. We take
le
a break now
loin pour une pause.
And return at 10:30. Court officer, please assist the civil party during the break time
votre soutien
and invite her as well as the TPO staff back into the courtroom.
Faire revenir la partie civile et le membre du personnel de la TPO dans le prétoire.
At 10:30, the court is now in recess.